Remember Sandy from our first presentation who was obese with BMI 32? Now, she is a trim BMI 18. Oh, did we mention she has also become a billionaire? So how did she get to lose weight and get super rich in the process? Sandy tried exercising and dieting but could not sustain it. She is too afraid to try bariatric surgery with the attached surgery risk. Sandy made her first million because she discovered that our gut microbiome is the key. And the answer is this gram-negative gut microbe Bacteriodetes Thetaiotaomicron. Let's just call it BT for short.
Obesity is a global epidemic. Every one of 10 adults is obese. Bacteriodetes, especially BT, is found in abundance in lean human gut, but little in obese humans. The primary degrader of polysaccharide, BT, produces short-chain fatty acids, acetate and propionate.
Acetate and propionate activate free fatty acid receptors, FFA2 and FFA3, on L cells. These hormones increase gut transition time, which also helps reduce food intake. They also travel to the hypothalamus to trigger appetite satiety. SCFAs also induces adiponectin in adipose tissue. Adiponectin increases fatty acid oxidation in skeletal muscles and suppresses lipid accumulation in the liver. Branched-chain fatty acid, BCAA, and its metabolite, glutamate, are found in abundance in obese humans than lean humans. Glutamine, on the other hand, is found in lean humans than obese humans.
BCCA overload in the skeletal muscles interferes with the complete oxidation of fatty acids, leading to accumulation of fatty acid coAs. BT can form endos obesity-inducing BCAA into metabolites, such as glutamine.
Obese humans with high-fat diet leads to increase in gram-negative bacteria. These bacteria produce and release LPLs from outer membrane, resulting in endotoxemia.
LPS attaches to TLR4, triggering the expression of pro-inflammatory cytokines such as TNF-alpha, interferon gamma that weaken the epithelial wall. LPS leaks into the circulation. In the liver, LPS decreases the peroxisomes, whose job is to break down fatty acids. This causes hepatic de novo lipogenesis that leads to increased adiposity. Gram-negative BT produces lipooligosaccharide, LOS, instead of LPS. BT mitigates endotoxemia in three ways. First, they upregulate host gene expression of IgA, IgG, prodefensin, cell cytosis, protecting nuclein. Second, they stimulate expression of small proline protein 2, SPRR2A, that reinforces the tight junctions joining the intestinal endothelial cells. Finally, BT triggers the PPAR gamma pathway, intercepting activated NFKB P65 component by forming complex and exporting them out of the nucleus, stopping them from pro-inflammatory protein expression. So Sandy sells BT as a probiotic therapy with its obesity prevention mechanism of byproducts acetate propionate and reduction of BCAA and endotoxemia.